Hello everyone, let's see this problem PRIME1 from Fair Online Judge. So in this problem we are given some number of test cases, and each test case we are given two inputs, that is n and m, and we have to find all the prime numbers between n and m inclusively. Now let's see the brute force approach for our problem, and then we eventually move out to optimized approach. So first up, we take the test cases to be t, we input the test cases, and then for each test case we input n and m, and then we traverse from n to m. And for each value between n and m, we check whether it's prime or not. So if prime I the output value, and then we output an empty line for the formatting of the output. Now we need to define this function prime. This takes one input I, let's say it's L, and in the brute force case we traverse from 2 to L minus 1, and we check if L is divisible by I, then we return 0, otherwise we return 1. Now to optimize our approach, let's see the factors of composite numbers, and we write it pairwise. So the first example that we take here is 16. So 16 has the following three pairs of factors. So it has 1 and 16, 2 and 8, 4 and 4. So we write, these are written in the following way. If one of both of them are multiplied, we get actually the number itself. So if one of the numbers is less than or equal to root of the number itself, then the other would be greater than or equal to the root. Since 16 is a perfect square, we get a pair that has actually both the factors which are equal. In case of 15, as we can see, these are the two pairs that we get, 1 and 15 and 3 and 5. So one is less than the root of 15 and another one is greater than the root of 15. So this is an actually important property that we are going to use to optimize our approach. Now let's optimize our code real quick. So in this case we are traversing from 2 to L minus 1, and we just need to change it to root L. So we are now traversing from 2 to root L. Okay, and another thing that we need to take care of is if L is 1, then we need to return 0. So this is an edge case that we need to take care of. Now let's see whether our solution is accepted or not. So here is the solution that I've copied from there. I submit it. And as we can see, the solution is getting accepted. Thanks for watching and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.